Today, we will learn about art appropriation and power poses to sketch our self-portrait inspired by Kehinde Wiley. So, who is Kehinde Wiley? Well, this is him, and he is an American portrait painter, meaning he paints pictures of people, and he is known for painting African Americans and appropriating old master paintings. Now, I know appropriation is a new word for you guys. So what do you think it means? Well, think of it as spoofing, kind of like we did with if Picasso painted a snowman. Just like the image on the right, it's when we borrow parts of other artworks with little or no change. But Kehinde Wiley's work is a bit different than spoofing. So spoofing can be a bit more fun, but his work is more serious and more powerful. And he is taking the power pose of the person and making it his own. So what is a power pose? Well, I'll give you a second to think. Think about superheroes. So, a power pose is when you make a pose that makes you seem powerful and confident. Some examples would be like superheroes, they are always nice and powerful. When you look at them, you think, wow, they are strong and confident. And I want you to pick which one of these two is a power pose. There's no wrong answers. I want you to just explain why that is a power pose. What is he doing that makes it seem really powerful? For example, on the image on the right with the red background, you can say it is a power pose because he is standing nice and tall with his head a little tilted, looking directly at you. And out of these two, which one do you think is the best power pose in your opinion? In my opinion, the image on the right could have a little improvement to make it a better power pose. For example, she could be arching her back more and doing something else with her hand to make her seem more confident.